Hello students, now I am discussing beta and gamma function from integral calculus. Firstly, let us define gamma function. The gamma function is denoted by gamma n and is defined by gamma n is equals to integration of 0 to infinity e to the power minus x into x to the power n minus 1 dx. For n greater than 0. Here all time n greater than 0. Let us define some properties on gamma function. Number 1, gamma n is a continuous and differentiable in n greater than 0. Number 2, gamma of n plus 1 is equals to n into gamma n, where n greater than 0. Number 3, gamma of n plus 1 is equals to n factorial, where n being positive integers. Gamma n plus 1 equals to n factorial, it is true whenever n being positive integers, and in this case n into gamma n when n greater than 0. So gamma n plus 1 equals to n factorial if n being a only positive integers. Okay. Number 4, gamma of 1 equals to 1. If we put here n equals to 1, we can see that gamma 1 is equals to 1. Number 5, gamma of half equals to root over pi. Here if we put n equals to half, then we can get the value gamma half equals to root pi. Let us define the beta function. The beta function is denoted by beta of mn and is defined for positive values of x and y by the integral beta of xy is equals to 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1 into 1 minus x whole to the power n minus 1 dx. Let us define beta function. The beta function denoted by beta of xy and is defined for positive values of x and y and by the integral beta of xy is equals to 0 to 1 t to the power x minus 1 1 minus t whole to the power y minus 1 dt, and here x and y must be positive number, that is x and y greater than 0. Hence beta function is defined as integration of 0 to 1 t to the power x minus 1 into 1 minus t whole to the power y minus 1 dt, and here x y greater than 0. Let us consider some important properties on beta function. Number 1, beta of xy is equals to beta of yx for x and y greater than 0. Number 2, beta of xy is equals to integration of 0 to infinity t to the power x minus 1 divided by 1 plus t to the power x plus y dt equals to 0 to infinity t to the power y minus 1 divided by 1 plus t x plus y dt, and here x y greater than 0. Okay, number 3, beta of xy is equals to 2 into integration of 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power 2x minus 1 theta into cos to the power 2y minus 1 theta d theta, and here xy greater than 0. Number 4, beta of half is equals to pi. If we put the value x and y on beta function, then we get beta half is equals to pi. Let us consider some important relation between beta and gamma functions. Number 1, beta of xy is equals to gamma x into gamma y divided by gamma x plus y, x and y greater than 0. Number 2, gamma half is equals to root pi. Number 3, 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power m theta into cos to the power n theta d theta saman 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power m theta into cos to the power n theta d theta is equals to half of beta m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2, and here in this case beta xy is equals to gamma x comma y divided by gamma x plus y, so gamma of m plus 1 by 2 into gamma of n plus 1 by 2 divided by gamma of x plus 2, and here m plus 1 by 2 plus n plus 1 by 2. Okay. Number 4, gamma x is equals to 2 into integration of 0 to infinity e to the power minus t square t to the power 2x minus 1 dt, x greater than 0. Now we consider some important problems on beta and gamma function. Number one problem, what is the value of 0 to infinity, integration of 0 to infinity, e to the power minus x into x to the power 3 by 2 dx. It can be written as 0 to infinity, e to the power minus x, x to the power 3 by 2. 3 by 2 can be written as x to the power 5 by 2 minus 1 dx. Since gamma function is defined as 0 to infinity, e to the power minus t, t to the power x minus 1 dx. So here n, or you can define which variable, that is gamma of 5 by 2. And because gamma n is defined as 0 to infinity e to the minus x, x to the power n minus 1, x to the power n minus 1, and this is equal to gamma n. So here gamma of 5 by 2, and this can be written as gamma of 3 by 2 plus 1, and gamma of n plus 1 is equal to n gamma n, that is 3 by 2 gamma, and 3 by 2 can be written as 1 plus half, that is half gamma half, and gamma half is equal to root pi. We considered it previously. Okay, this is equal to 3 by 4 into root 5. Problem number 2, what is the value of 0 to infinity e to the power minus a square x square dx? This can be written as e to the power minus x whole square. Now put x equal to z, and on new variable the limit of integration is remain invariant, that is limit is same, 0 to infinity e to the power minus z square dz by a. And now let us put z square equals to u, and here limit is same as before, so 1 by a 0 to infinity to minus u du by 2 into root u, that is 1 by 2a into 0 to infinity to minus u, and e to the minus half, and e to the minus half can be written as half minus 1, that is this is equals to 1 by 2a gamma of half, and gamma of half is equals to root pi, that is root pi divided by 2a. It is the required result. Number 3 problem, 0 to infinity to the power alpha into e to the minus t square dt is equals to option A, half of gamma alpha plus 1 by 2 or alpha greater than 0, B, 1 by 2 gamma of alpha plus 1 by 2 alpha greater than minus 2, C, 1 by 2 half of gamma of alpha plus 1 by 2 or alpha greater than 1, and half of gamma alpha plus 1 by 2 gamma greater than 1. This is PSC 2014 problem. Here let us put t square equals to u. So t equals to e to the power half 2t dt equal to du, and in this case also limit is same as before. So integration of 0 to infinity t means e to the power half, that is e to the power alpha by 2 e to the power minus u du by 2 into e to the power half. This can be written as half of integration of 0 to infinity e to the power minus u u to the power alpha by 2 minus 1 by 2, okay, du, and this is equals to half of integration of 0 to infinity e to the power minus u, and this can be written as u to the power alpha plus 1 upon 2 minus 1, okay, and this is equals to half of gamma alpha plus 1 by 2, and we consider it n greater than 0. So in this case alpha plus 1 by 2 is also 0, that is alpha plus 1 by 2 greater than 0, that is alpha plus 1 greater than 0, and from this we can written as alpha greater than minus 1. Hence option C is the correct answer. Okay, I will discuss on this topic with upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.